Hamisvah Kav Gimel, 23rd Misvah. Hasivui Shini Stavu Alim Lvad. La'avod b'mikdash pa'avodot yiduot. The instruction, the Misvah that was instructed to only the Levi'im to serve in the Mikdash with specific duties. Kegon, Ne'ilat Sha'arim, Faminat Ashir Bet HaKorban, like closing the gates and reciting the Shir, the song, like the Shir Shel Yom, the time of the Korban. Ve'omro. Ve'avad al-Levi hu et avodat ohel moed. Ve'lashon tzifre, shomea anim lo se ya'avod, v'im lo rasa lo ya'avod. Ve'bon lomar ve'avad al-Levi hu al-korcho. This pasuk, that the Levi, he should serve. I learned from this, if he wants to, maybe he should, he could, and if he doesn't, he doesn't have to. Rather, the pasuk, Talmud lomar, says, ve'avad al-Levi hu. Al korcho, even against his will, kilomach zehova alab umisva mutilet alab bechreach. He's forced to do it. This is his job. This is his responsibility. Uchbani paer ma'i avodat alvim azot bechama mekom betamid umidot. He's already explained various times. Mitpaer gam ken pekbet me'arachim she'en omrim shir el alvim. Only the levim are allowed to say the shir, sing the shir. Uchbani nichpal sivui misva zot b'shon ached. We see this instruction in different language in the Torah. It says, "Vesheret b'shem Adonai Elohav, hechol echav alvim." He should serve the Levi in the name of God, just like his other brethren, the Levim. Ve'amru perek bet me'arachin. Eze u'sherut b'shem Hashem. What does that mean to serve in the name of God? Heve omer zo shira. That is the shira, the song that the Levim would sing the time of Bet HaMikdash. The time of the Korban. The 24th Misvah. Hasivui shenistavu ha-Kohanim l'chose dehem ragleihem. This is only a Misvah for the Kohanim. The previous halakha was a Misvah just for the Levim. This one's just for the Kohanim to wash their hands and their feet. Kol pa'am shiistarechu l'ikanes la'echal l'karev la'avoda v'zoi Misvah kidush ha-Rayim ragleihem. Anytime they were entering in to the holy part of the Beit HaMikdash, to the Echal, or to come close to do the Avodah, they had to wash their hands and their feet. That Aaron and his children, and all the Kohanim, should wash their hands and their feet upon entering into Ohel Moed to serve. If someone, a Kohen, transgresses this mitzvah is hayav mita in the hands of God. Kilomar shekohen sheshimesh b'mikdash. Im lo rachatz yadayim v'raglayim. A kohen served in the mikdash and did not wash his hands or his feet. Hayav mita b'dei shemayim. Ve'omro yitale. Yirhasu mayim lo yamutu. There in the pesukim, in perek lamed, in shemot, it says they should wash with the water v'lo yamutu and not die. Meaning that they would die in the hands of God, b'dei shamayim, if they served without washing. Uchbar nitpayenu dine mitzvah zo bishlemut perek bet mizevachim. Right in the second chapter of Zevachim, Harambam mentions that this mitzvah was explained in its entirety, with all of its details, in the second chapter of Zevachim. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen.